All right, so what we're gonna prepare here is a background for a sky. I've got a pretty pearlescent kind of light blue here. This is called Metallic. It's by Folk Art, ice blue, it's very pretty. And we're gonna use a little bit of that. We're gonna use a little bit of Fusion Mineral Paint Encasement, which is white. We're gonna kick it up a notch with the white. This one, this blue, it's gonna be a pretty blue sky. This blue is called Cayman Blue, and it is also by Folk Art. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna muddle it all the way through. See all that paint I got on there? Got lots. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm just gonna get right in here with this blue, and I'm just gonna kind of pounce it. I need more white. I'm gonna put a little puddle of white off to the side so I can pick it up as I go. I think I'll do that. And there's no rhyme or reason to this, y'all. So I'm gonna just dry it up because what I have to do is I'm gonna show you how to make a cloud. A little bit. Okay, this over here for now. I'm going to grab a paintbrush and show you how to a little bit of this titanium. Doesn't need a lot. Okay. Get it on your brush like that and blend it. What happens is the white and the blue, they blend together and they look just like a real cloud. Right? Looks like a storm is brewing. Right. Okay, so now you're gonna see, I took a piece of this. This is actually paper made for watercolor. Couldn't think of the word. Watercolor. But I used it for acrylic color and I think it turned out swell. You can see that, okay? We got some clouds up there. See my clouds? Got a few clouds. And what I've done is I've penciled in a leprechaun and I'm gonna paint him if I can see him. And he's a gnome leprechaun. He's not your average, you know, everyday leprechaun. He's just a leprechaun. So I'm gonna go ahead and paint him in real quick. And then we're gonna get the blinging because we got some blinging to do. Because I wanna bling, I wanna add some bling to this rainbow. And of course, we've got a pot of gold. Hello, that's gonna be bling, bling, blung, right? All right, I'm gonna take my palette back, that little one. And I don't know if you can see this little gnome or not, but I'll hold him up close to the camera and see if you can see where I've penciled him in. Can you kind of see him? You can sort of kind of see him there, right? Got a big nose, got a gnome hat, it's gonna have a beard. It's gonna be very cute-ish. He's kind of standing right on top of that pot of gold. So here is my little gnomey guy. I need a little bit of brown and a little bit of, I'm gonna make his nose. Of course, his nose could be pink or red. Who knows, gnome colors. I'm just gonna kind of make a little bit of a, I'm gonna take a brown and a cream color and I'm gonna mix them together. And hopefully I'm gonna get like a flesh tone over here. I need to get out some extra green here. That's for sure. This is just Anita's Christmas green. I like it. It's a Christmas green. But I am gonna mix just a little bit of this lime green in here, just on the side. Just a little. All right, here we go. Right along the edge of his hat. Just gonna outline it with my little script liner. Just like that. And go right over top of that rainbow a little bit. Right here. This is the brim of his hat that I'm doing here. Just a little brim. Like that. Okay. And then I'm going to go in with like a dip, like how much, kind of like muddled. A little bit of light green, a little bit of dark green. I'm going to use both. I'm going to make it shaded a little. That itty bitty bit of brown that I got there, I'm going to go in there and I'm going to paint some brown boots. So, okay, now he's got to have a beard, correct? So what we need, we're going to go ahead and we're going to give him a white beard, and then I'm going to go in and I'm going to give him some brown streaks. Okay. But I'm going to go in here with my little brush and make itty bitty little streaks coming all the way down to his boots. Goody. Okay, so I'm gonna go in now, just a little bit of brown right on the same, right over the white, using that same little bit of brown that we used for the boots. We're just gonna fill in his beard and he will be done all but the highlighting. Okay, now you can see him standing on his pot of gold. He's staking his claim. He says, that's it, you're not in, you're out. Okay, I'm just gonna go in here with my little liner brush and I'm gonna give him a little bit of highlights up here over his hat, right here, one over, a couple over his nose of this titanium white. Like that, and some around the brim here, just kind of outlining it like that. Okay, intents and purposes is done. So I'm going to take off this painter's tape and we are going to reveal the perfectly my perfect little lines here, right? And a little painting. Just a cute little painting. Now comes the fun. So I am going to go in here with my V7000 and I'm going to run a pretty bead of, a bead of bling in my rainbow. Because why not, right? All right, so I've got some beautiful colors here to work with. Let me see here. Do I want, there's this pretty green here. Oh, it's a blue green. I'm not sure which rainbow I'll put it on. Probably between the blue and the green here. Right there, that would be beautiful. Let's do that. Put a little bead of B7000. Right here, because I don't like this slow bling stuff. I like to bling it up quick so you can kind of see real quick like how pretty it's going to be. I like the instant gratification kind of thing, you know. Yeah. That gorgeous. Look at that, y'all. Isn't that pretty? I love that. Oh my goodness gracious. Pour out some of this number three. It's very close. I'm going to go up here. Get this number. Look at how pretty. Look at the sparkle and shine. Love it. Okay. Got some orangey ones here. I'm gonna do kind of orange between the orange and the yellow. what's next? We need like a purplish color here. Use these pinky color ones next. How beautiful this is. Look at how pretty that shimmers and shines. I mean, I thought it was pretty to begin with, but man, it went crazy. There's a regular ruby, and that was ruby shimmer. I'm gonna do the rose. The next one is rose. The one next. Oh my goodness. All right, so we've got some blues going on in here and purples and all of that stuff. So the next one I think I'm going to do is this, like, it's called, let's see, hold on, let's see what they call this. This number 5, sapphire. It is sapphire. Stunning bling. Wow. Actually, there's one more here in between. I want to get one more in there. 7. Light sapphire shimmer. Right? Seriously, you guys, look at that. My gosh. Whew. I love it. It really came to life. Okay, so I want to show you what I got here for my bling tonight. This piece is going to get attached back on to this with the clouds. Remember this that I did in the beginning with the clouds? This piece is going to get attached in the middle to that. Okay. I'm not real sure what I'm going to do with that white border. I may paint it. I may paint it a darker color. I don't know. I might just leave it white. I'm not sure. But what I do know is that it's going to go right in the center. And if I need to add a cloud or two at the bottom, I'll do that as well. But what I have going here is these little, my little shamrocks. Okay, we're going to put the shamrocks on. We're going to put one on the little guy's hat here. Okay, so one little shamrock is going to go on his hat here. Where does it lay? Like right here. Then I'm going to go in between here. Maybe one here, 1, 2, 3. I'm going to put this, I think I'm going to do one on the red because it's wider and it fits in there better. It doesn't fit in between the, scooch it down. There we go. This one right here. Because I'm going to put, we got to put gold in the pot, right? We've got Totally Dazzled pieces here. Some gold, pot of gold. There's a pot of gold is here. I'm going to put just like this. This reminds me of a clover, of a four-leaf clover, which is good luck, right? So I'm going to use that one. And I think I'm going to put it right down here at the bottom. Okay. Then this one. It's going to go right up at the top of the lip of the pot. Okay. That is it. I'm going to attach it to this piece here. I don't know. That. But I think instead of attaching it right now while I'm rushed, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this inside the frame, show you the frame that I'm going to use. Here's the frame. I'm gonna show you what it's gonna look like this way, and that way I can take my time and mount it nicely and add a cloud or two if I need to and all of that stuff. So what do you guys think of that? I'm not really sure what I'm gonna do with that edge. I may keep it, I may color it, but anyway, there it is in all of its glory. I'm gonna put it up close so you can see my little leprechaun gnome dude and his pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. Because isn't that where it is? It's at the end of the rainbow, right?
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.